President Donald Trump destroys Rapey Senator Al Franken by asking one damning question. The country was stunned when news came out that Senator Al Franken was exposed for groping a woman while she was asleep. While the liberal media tried to downplay it, the photo of the man touching the woman's breasts quickly went viral. Many are now calling for the senator to step down. Franken, for his part, could only give a half-hearted apology. Finally, President Trump has weighed in on the matter, and he didn't hold back. Recent months have revealed a horrifying trend across both politics and the entertainment world. More and more high-profile figures are being outed as serial sex offenders. These men have abused their positions of power to take advantage of vulnerable women, men, and even children. There seems to be no end in sight. It's especially bad when elected officials are outed. Americans are disgusted to learn that the people they trusted to lead them would behave so poorly. Yet, despite the obvious hypocrisy shown by men like Al Franken, who regularly lectured conservatives on women's issues, many within his party and in the media are trying to ignore it. Last night, President Donald Trump spoke out about the Al Franken photo. He minced no words when expressing what he thought about the man. Some might criticize the president for weighing in on the matter, but let's be frank here. When audio surfaced, during the election campaign, of Donald Trump simply saying a few rude things, the media exploded. Newscasters were calling for him to step down from the race. Others accused Trump of being a predator. The left was merciless in their attempts to destroy his campaign, all because of a few vulgar words. Now, we have actual photographic proof of a liberal senator doing something completely inappropriate. This is far more than words, folks. He had no problem touching her, as a joke, for a picture. There is nothing good about that situation. The woman was clearly violated and shocked. What Trump brought up is also very important. Where did his hands go in pictures 2, 3, 4, and so on? The victim, Lynn Tweedon, claims the man kissed her without her consent. That's pretty disgusting behavior for a man who claims to support women's rights. You wrote the scene that would include you kissing me and then relentlessly badgered me into rehearsing the kiss with you backstage when we were alone. You knew exactly what you were doing. You forcibly kissed me without my consent, grabbed my breasts while I was sleeping and had someone take a photo of you doing it, knowing I would see it later, and be ashamed. While debating whether or not to go public, I even thought to myself, so much worse has happened to so many others, maybe my story isn't worth telling? But my story is worth telling. Source, CABC. Some lawmakers are calling for an ethics investigation, for good reason. There is the possibility that Franken continued this kind of behavior while in Washington, D.C. Are there other women who have been violated? Do they have stories to tell? The fact that this is happening as more stories emerge of misconduct in D.C., things might not go so well for Franken. It's high time we cleaned up our country. Nobody who assaults women should be in positions of power. This kind of behavior has been covered up in the past, thanks to the silence of liberal cohorts. Those days are over.